El Shaddai, Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, Elkom Kono Adonai. I will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham.
Hey, and praise God for this glorious day. Welcome you back to another edition of What Jesus Says, where the Lord provides us with insight on controversial issues facing us today. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. And we thank you for being with us tonight. We're looking forward to a great conversation. And let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, we thank you, Jesus, for another day, another opportunity to win souls for the kingdom. We bless your name at all times. Your praise shall continually be in our mouths. Bless us and keep us in your care. We pray for those that are less fortunate, those in hospitals, nursing homes, hospices all throughout the country, those that are unemployed, those that are homeless, those incarcerated, even those that are on death row. We pray for your apostles, prophets, evangelists, preachers, teachers, local and universal. We pray for your leaders all over the world. We pray for our enemies that they cease from troubling. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem, that we prosper, that love the holy city. Peace be with our gates, prosperity in our palaces. We pray for the salvation of Israel, that they come to know you as their God, Lord, and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray for our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and marines, and all our men and women in uniform on watch over us. And we lift up this broadcast in your name, Lord God, that we win souls for the kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We hope you guys are going to have a great Labor Day weekend. So let's get started.
Hello?
Hello, who do we have on the line tonight?
You have Annie Mae Mitchum on the line today.
You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
All right, so get your word, turn off everything, get off all your distractions, and we're getting ready to get started.
All right, let's turn the TV off.
Tonight, we're going to discuss sometimes a serpent, a snake, can be helpful to you. And we're going to get our word and we're going to start reading. All right, you ready?
Yes.
All right, go ahead and get Numbers 28. You can write them down. 21. Numbers 21:8.
Wait just a moment. Let me get a pencil and paper.
Sister, you moving too slow. What's wrong with you?
All right, 21:8.
John 3:14.
Matthew 10:16.
And Genesis 3:1. All right, so let's go to Genesis 3:1 first. Ready?
Genesis 3:1.
Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. I just want you to read that first part. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. Did you get that?
Read that one more time.
He said, now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
What do you understand?
What do you
about
understand?
That the snake was more stubborn than anything else. That.
In other words, snake was wise,
snake
right?
Wise. Right?
Yeah.
All right, so let's go to Matthew 10:16. This is what the Lord said. And like I said, the nice conversation is about how sometimes a snake can be useful to you. Every time you see a snake, people normally take the first reaction is to run. But sometimes a snake can be useful. Now watch this. Matthew 10:16. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves.
Be
ye therefore wise
as serpents
and harmless as doves.
Now
what the Lord is telling you, you need to observe
a serpent.
You need to study
a snake.
He says a snake is wise.
Now
wise, wisdom is not a negative attribute of an individual, is it? You look for wisdom. He said let a man ask for wisdom where he lacks wisdom, right? The Lord gives wisdom liberally, unabraded.
And
that what he said?
That's what he
said.
All right, so
why didn't we take notice to the word while he was telling us to be wise
as a serpent? See, we just listen to these scriptures. We don't take them to heart. So if we were wise as a serpent, we would have to study the serpent to see what the Lord means by that. Don't you think?
Yeah.
So how is a serpent wise? Have you ever seen a serpent catch a bird?
A
snake doesn't even have arms or legs, yet he's able to catch a bird.
How is that?
Well, what do you mean then? Since a snake can't do those things, how would it be wise?
A snake can catch
a bird.
That's what I'm trying to
tell
you.
How can
a snake
catch
a bird? He ain't got no legs.
He
can't fly.
But
what happens is he waits till
the
bird goes to the water.
Everything
has to have
water,
don't it?
Yeah.
That's wisdom.
It is wise.
Because he got to
fly.
All he had to do is wait till the food come to him.
God
feed
the snake too.
So the snake, he waits till the bird comes to the water to get the water from the lake or
the river,
and he slides his little sneaky self up there. Don't make
no
noise. The bird can't
smell
him. And as soon as he gets up on
that
bird close
enough,
he'll pounce on him. Now
that's
wisdom, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
And once he pounces on him, he'll just
eat him.
Feathers and all, bones
and
everything, and the chemicals within
the snake
will digest
that
bird. Now that's wisdom.
That's
why you have
to
study.
Now
the Lord then
says,
catch people
while
they're
unaware.
And then that's when you make
your move.
In the street,
they
say they
catch
you
slipping.
So the Lord is telling
you
don't ever get
caught
slipping. He wants you to study that
snake.
Because he said
the
snake is the
most
subtle,
the most
crafty,
the
most wise
animal
in the kingdom.
A
snake
can't
do a lot of
things
that other
animals
do,
but
he's just
as
powerful
and strong.
They take the snake's
venom
to cure you
from
snake
poison
when you get bit
by
a snake,
right?
Yes.
Do you understand what I'm telling you?
I'm trying to understand. You tell me a whole lot at one time. I just hear you teaching.
Okay.
I'm going to try to understand it later.
Okay.
But right now, I'm focusing on how wide that snake is.
That snake,
That's what he told you to do, study
to show yourself approved. A workman need not
be
ashamed, rightly dividing
the
word of
truth.
So if he tell
you
to understand
how
a snake is, let's
go
to another example of
a snake.
He even
compares
that
to
Moses
in
the
wilderness.
Now watch this.
Go to
your
scripture,
Numbers.
Yeah,
I guess
you're
right. If you
want to
participate in the
night's
conversation, dial
919-747-3572.
This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Said. All right, so let's start with the seventh verse. This is when the children of Israel in the wilderness was up there murmuring and complaining. It ain't good for people to murmur and complain against God's chosen people. You understand? So they were murmuring and complaining, and this is what happened. Numbers 21:7. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away these serpents from us. And Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said unto Moses, Make thee a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon that pole, he shall live. So he used the serpent as an emblem of healing. And if you look on your medical field, you'll see the caduceus. They call it the caduceus. That's the snake on the pole. Have you seen that? The snake when you go to the hospital or the apothecary, when you go to Walgreens or somebody to get your prescription, you see that snake on that pole?
Yes.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you never knew what that was about?
No, that's why we got what Jesus says.
You guys don't show no energy. Y'all ain't putting out no energy. Okay, so let's see how this snake could be helpful to us. Because sometimes y'all see people as snakes, which they are, but you need to see how that snake can benefit you. Everything that comes out of their venom out of their mouth can be used to heal you. You understand? But you got to take it with a grain of salt and look at it, how it can be used to go against them. You flip the script. You understand? Let's see what Jesus had to say about this snake when it came to him. So let's go back to our scripture read. Go to Matthew. Y'all ain't showing me no energy. Matthew 10:16. Now he's talking to. No, let's go to John. Hold on. We already read that. We're going to John now. John 3:14. That's right before a very popular scripture. Now watch this.
And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life.
You understand? So the Lord is emblematic. That was a foreshadowing of Jesus having to come to be lifted up. And he said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. So when they look upon that cross, that's the source of salvation. And it's just like he said in Numbers, if they look upon that cross, they'll be saved. Isn't that what you read?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So that's a foreshadowing of things to come. When he was talking about Moses, he said, Moses, these people have sinned. Those people came to Moses and said, we've sinned, we talked against the Lord. Pray for us, help us. And he said, I'm going to do the same thing Moses did, but I'm the sacrifice. And when they look upon me, I'm not a snake. But when they look upon me, they'll be healed. So Jesus is the balm of Gilead, right? He's a healing factor of our sin-sick souls. So when they lifted him up on that pole, everybody that looked to that tree, looked to the hills from which cometh thy help. Thy help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. They'll be saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run to him, and they are saved. Huh? I don't call you woman. I call you by your name. He said, if my people are called by my name. See, y'all calling folk God, this, that, God. I don't know who you're talking about. You better start saying his name. Why don't y'all say Jesus? He said, at the name of Jesus. Ain't no power in no other name but Jesus. Ain't no power in God. Because the people got God all over the place. You could be Buddha. You could be Mercedes Benz. But when you want somebody to address you, how do you want them to address you? Girl?
Woman?
How do you want people to address you?
By your name.
My God. He said, there is no other name under heaven or earth that anybody can be saved. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You understand? There is nothing greater under heaven or earth except the name of Jesus. So y'all need to flip that God, this God, that. Anything can be God. Who you calling on? He said, my people call by my name. God ain't a name, is it? Don't you know Baal is a God? Who you calling on, Baal? Elijah said, look, y'all better call on your God. Because he might be on a vacation. He got a name. God, the name of our God is Jesus Christ. That's why in America they don't have no God. They don't have a provision for a God because the Constitution won't allow it. You can't infringe on any religion, but you can't have any national religion. Because if you did, then you would infringe on somebody else's right. So everybody doing their thing. But see, his people are called by his name. See, God, that's easy. You can put God on the money, and God we trust, because your God can be the money. Do you understand what I'm telling you? The God can be the money. They don't care nothing about it. Now, you put in Jesus we trust on that money. Do you think you're going to have some problem with that?
Yeah, people don't want to acknowledge that Jesus is Lord.
You ain't lying. You're going to have some problems with that. Homeboy, what you doing? Jesus. In Jesus, which Jesus I don't think nothing about no Jesus.
What now?
Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith.
Without question. And without and him, nobody's saved. And that's a good segment. Let me go to some break right here, and then we'll come back and start eating on that so we can discuss it. Y'all ain't got no energy tonight.
This ain't no ordinary words. This ain't no ordinary song, yeah. The God of some is greater than the ordinary. So I'ma give them all I have, invisible. Come on, help me say, tell a story about a woman with an issue. Had it 12 long years, didn't know what to do. She heard about a man coming through her town. She fell to her knees and crawled on the ground. This is what she said, yo. She said, if I could only touch, but the giver of his garment, I'ma give it all I have in the moment. Come on, help me say, yo.
This ain't no ordinary words.
Oh, no, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't.
This ain't no ordinary
words. Yeah. The God of service. Crucified for you and me. Oh,
Tells us in Romans 10:9, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, you're saved, because with the mouth confession is made to salvation, and with the heart belief is made into righteousness. We believe that. And in Luke 11:13, we also believe that you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. How much more will your heavenly Father give you the Holy Ghost if you ask? I think I've been quoting this for a long time. Luke 10:13. I've been saying Luke 10:13, but it's Luke 11:13. That if you being evil know how to give your children good gifts, how much more will your heavenly Father give you the Holy Ghost if you ask? Now listen, y'all gonna have to come big some energy about this particular conversation we're talking about with snakes. Y'all don't know no snakes in your life that they came to be there to help you.
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
It's breaking in and out.
Okay.
Now what did you say?
I said, do you know any snakes that were in your life that came to help you?
To help you?
Yeah. Was there any serpents in your life to help you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead and expound on that. Tell me about it.
Well, my serpent came to deceive, to say they had my back and I could depend on them. And when all things came out, realized they were stealing and taking something that was not belonging to them. And that serpent allowed me to do something different to get help. And by me seeking help and getting rid of that serpent, I got better. And I didn't realize how much better it would have been had I not had to go through that serpent act of deception.
Sometimes the Lord says your trials come to make you strong to work for patience. You understand? And when patience has its perfect way, you'll be lifted up, you'll be exalted. He said, don't be weary well doing because you reap your harvest if you faint not. When these things come, they didn't come to destroy you. They came to push you out of your nest. Like if I had not been pushed out of my nest, I would still been in Macon, Georgia, working a fast food joint. Living with my mom. I love her, but I don't want to live all my life, right? Can you imagine a 61-year-old boy laying on your couch?
You breaking in and out.
Can you imagine a 61-year-old boy lying on your mother's couch?
I know, right? And you got some people do that.
That ain't gonna work.
Now, you love them, but you don't want...
Look, if I had not been pushed out, I would have been in bad shape.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So she ain't got no experiences with snakes that helped her.
Yeah. I remember her telling a story how women would come tell her negative things about her husband. They were snakes, and they were the actual ones that were doing what they was trying to say someone else is doing. And what that did was pushed her into being as blessed as she is now, because she didn't leave her husband. She stayed with her husband, and she supported her husband. So what the devil meant for evil, it actually turned around for her good by sticking by.
So there's a blessing in the messing?
Excuse me?
Is there a blessing in the messing?
There was a blessing in it, yeah.
So when we say Pee-wee, do you know who Pee-wee is?
Who?
Pee-wee.
No.
Ask her who Pee-wee is.
Pee-wee. Yeah. Pee-wee. Which, I wonder which Pee-wee. No, I can't get a face. the name sound for me. But I can't get his face.
We don't know who Pee-wee is. She don't know who Perch is.
Let me see. Who was Pee-wee? You can't think about who was Pee-wee.
They used to call Chef Pee-wee.
You remember EJ?
Then T.T. called Chef Pee-wee.
Oh, when he's talking about Tank. Tank is not Pee-wee.
Can she hear me?
Yeah.
You breaking in and out. That's why it's not
okay,
clear.
Well, I'll get better with the technology, but Chef is Pee-wee.
Oh, Daddy, they call Daddy Pee-wee.
Oh, yeah.
Talk about oh, yeah. Talk about his name sound familiar.
His family call, referred to him as that.
Wait a minute. How can you forget that?
Not us. We you don't know that thing. You don't remember that name.
Okay, so we're going to wrap this up because everybody down there probably just woke up. But anyway, I want the audience to know that sometimes your adversary can be used as a tool to help you out, just like Joseph was placed in a pit by his brother. And so because they were adversarial, it drove him to his destiny. You understand? If I had been so wrapped around my emotional state when I left that hometown, I wouldn't be as successful as I am today. So hopefully you learned something from our small conversation on sometimes serpents can work towards your good. But they knew you was just like the little girl that picked up the snake in the cold because she felt sorry for him. And she brought the snake in and nurtured the snake, brought the snake back to help. And the snake thawed out because it was so frozen. And once the thing thawed out, it bit her. And she was surprised. He said, "Why'd you bite me? I took care of you. And everything you, I did everything for you." He said, "You knew was I was a snake before you picked me up." All right. So go ahead and wrap it up and pray for it.
You gonna pray me?
Dear Lord, thank you for your many blessings. And help us, Lord, to do your will daily. Mm-hmm. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Now, if you want to hear the rebroadcast, you go to www.spreaker, S-P-R-E-A-K-E-R.com. Spreaker.com. And we'll look forward to having you again on another edition of What Jesus Said.
Come on, master. teach me to pray. Teach me to walk right. Teach me to talk right. Oh, teach me how to pray. Oh, yeah. We'll bow at the altar. Oh, teach me.